Check.
We will be starting the funeral service shortly. Would you please take your seats?
Hello. 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 Hello.
This is okay, this one. Shalom.
Hello, hello.
Good afternoon, family and friends. I welcome you into this gathering which is made with a sacred spirit of love and friendship which you bring to this gathering this afternoon. So on behalf of Reverend Dr. Francis Sundararaj's family, I would like to say thank you for all of you for having come this afternoon and also for those who have joined us online. Let us begin with a word of prayer. Almighty God, remind us as we gather this afternoon in this service that none of us lives to himself or none of us dies to himself. We are yours whether we are living in this life or whether we have passed on into life beyond to be with you. If we live, O Lord, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, for they rest from their labor, and God, you take us to be with you. Be our Alpha and Omega in this entire funeral service, O Father, and we pray that you will be honored and we will be comforted and encouraged. This we pray in the matchless name of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen. Shall we now rise as we sing our opening hymn number, Be Thou My Vision? It's also displayed on the screen.
Thank you.
please take your seats. I would now request Bishop Sampath Kumar to please come forward and give us an exhortation.
Kindly permit me to use first names because I never addressed him as either Reverend Francis Sundararaj or Dr. Francis Sundararaj, nor did he call me or address me as a Reverend or a Right Reverend. Reason. 60 years ago, this past June, both of us together entered the seminary. And from then on, we call each other by our first names. One of his favorite verses is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. The accent for Francis was not on I can, but the accent was through Christ. Single-minded person with one consuming passion to be faithful to the Lord who had called him. That was Francis. A few months ago, I took a few friends of mine to sing for the senior citizens who are living in our home here in this church. After we sang a few songs, I asked them, "Do you want us to sing any familiar or favorite songs or hymns of yours?" Of course, the first one was to respond was Mary, and she said, "This is my father's world." After that, it was Francis who said, and I was surprised that this was the song that he asked for. "Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not all else to me save thou art. Thou my best thought by day and by night, waking or sleeping, still be my vision, ruler of all." Not a very familiar hymn, but that was his vision. Single-minded with one consuming passion to be a man of integrity, a man of faithfulness to the calling that he received from the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he were dead, he will live." Francis today is alive in Jesus. He lives in Jesus. Praise be to God. And may the God of comfort be close to particularly the family and all the near and dear ones. Amen.
The psalmist says, "Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of the saints." And even as Bishop truly said, he was a man of vision. And many of you know that he had been associated with the EFI and especially with the children's ministry. And here we have this evening Mrs. Lata Samuel, who will come and give the second exhortation.
To me and my family, Reverend Franz Sundararaj was always pastor. And our children growing up, they called him Pastor Uncle. So he was very, very close to our family. And it's my privilege to say a few words about him and the verses that he liked. One of the verses that we emphasize in CFE. CFE is Christian Education of the EFI, Evangelical Fellowship of India. And the verse that we always emphasize was Colossians 1:28. It says, "He is the one we proclaim, admonishing and teaching everyone with all wisdom, so that we may present everyone fully mature in Christ." That was the verse of CFE, because the focus of CFE was to make disciples of Jesus Christ by leading them to Christ for salvation and helping them to grow in Jesus to maturity and to help them to discover, develop, and use their God-given talents for His glory. So salvation, service, salvation, growth, and service were the catchwords of CFE. And Pastor Sundararaj, we emphasize in our teaching, all our teaching, that this is done not only in our teaching and preaching, but in everyday life as we meet people, as we interact with people. So as we interact with people, we talk to them about the Lord, the love of Jesus, the forgiveness, etc. And as we, that is leading them to know more about Jesus and then to grow in Jesus. As we talk in our daily conversation, we'll be talking about forgiveness, unselfishness, and etc., biblical truths, and help them to discover their talents and use them for the Lord. And Pastor Sundararaj lived this in his life, because every time we had a Christian education workshop, he used to meet with each individual. Individually meet with them and talk to them. And he, within 2 days, he insisted that we had to learn all 30, 40 names, all their names. And every single person he would spend time with. And every time we went on a training workshop, whenever I was teaching, he would give company to, he'll be talking to my children, or he used to sit and chat with my husband Alex, spend a lot of time. So, and another very special thing about Pastor Sundararaj was, every time we had EFI conference in different places, he never stayed in the guest room that was provided for the General Secretary. He always lived with families. I remember 2 occasions he stayed with us, though we had just one bathroom with 6 of us, 4 children and 2 of us. With all that, he would adjust, he and Banu Akka, and one time Vinod was also with us, and they were so adjusting. Early morning, they'll get up, even before any of us would get up, have their bath, so that the bathroom would be free for our school-going children. He was so adjusting, and so much, he spent so much time with everyone, and he truly practiced what we taught, to present everyone perfect, mature in Jesus Christ. That was the motto of safety. Thank you.
This evening we have a few exhortations which come in from 4 or 5 people and 3 tributes. And we have told all the speakers that it's going to be short and sweet. It's only going to be 3 minutes. So we have a lot of speakers who are going to be coming in, but now you will join us even as we sing one of his favorite hymns, "Great is Thy Faithfulness." We'll be seated as we sing this beautiful song, "Great is Thy Faithfulness." next exhortation is being given by Ms. Leela Manasseh, and she would be talking about EFI and the associations thereof.
Dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, how grateful I am to God for this privilege to pay this short tribute to our dear departed brother, Pastor Uncle Francis. And I'm grateful to the family for giving me this privilege to share what God did in his life in order to encourage and inspire ourselves to be faithful to God as he was faithful to God always. I had the joy of serving the Lord through the Evangelical Fellowship of India, Evangelical Fellowship of Asia, and the World Evangelical Alliance alongside Pastor Francis and the entire team from all over India in the context of EFI and all over Asia in the context of Evangelical Fellowship of Asia and in WEA from all over the world. What a joy it was for me to see the faithfulness of God that was extended to our dear Pastor Francis right from 1978 when I joined till Pastor retired in EFI, later in EFA 2004. In EFI till 1998. One of the favorite and most meaningful scripture texts of Pastor Francis was, "Faithful is the one who has called you, and he will do it," as we find in the Pauline epistle, first epistle to the believers at Thessalonica, chapter 5, verse 24. Indeed, it was true in the life, family, work, ministry, and all interrelationships of our dear departed Pastor Francis Uncle. And he was a pastor uncle to all of us. At that time, you can imagine, in 1978, most of us who are leaders today, we were young adults. And a host of us in India, in Asia, and in the world around knew that Pastor Francis was blessed by God with a pastoral heart and an administrative mind. So he was both firm and understanding, loving, kind, and also a person who was highly disciplined. So we praise God for our mentor who showed us through his life, family, ministry, work, and witness what it is to understand the faithfulness of God upon each one of us when the Lord called us, and how God will be faithful to each one of us, and how God honors faithfulness in each one's life. Even if I fail, God continues to be faithful. In the midst of many creative challenges, I have witnessed how Pastor Francis trusted the Lord with especially his whole heart to experience the faithfulness of God Almighty in his own life, in his family life, and in the ministry. Evangelical Fellowship of India had a new touch when Pastor Francis became the General Secretary. He was earlier CP Secretary, General Secretary, then subsequently became the General Secretary of EFI, and how God honored him as he honored God. Yes, we followed that example. We continue to honor God. If we honor God, surely God will honor us. And God's faithfulness to Pastor Francis, when he later became the General Secretary of Evangelical Fellowship of Asia, it was indeed great. We, the Women's Commission of Asia Evangelical Alliance, went forward as forerunners in order to form the evangelical fellowships in the Asian context. And then Pastor Francis' leadership to the Evangelical Fellowship of Asia built up the National Evangelical Alliances. And Pastor Francis' engagement with the International Council of the World Evangelical Alliance further brought in new insights, and particularly the discipling of the nations was one of the focuses of the WEA. And the theme was, the vision was, discipling the world by the discipled people of God. That was there. And new departments began in the Evangelical Fellowship of Asia, and Women's Commission was further strengthened, and I was trusted with the leadership. And praise God that women and men started working alongside each other faithfully for the Lord, because Pastor encouraged men and women working side by side. We did a lot of research under his leadership and brought into the decision-making body of the World Evangelical Alliance and the Evangelical Fellowship of Asia, as well as Evangelical Fellowship of India, men and women into the decision-making body, mainstream of the body. They were the shakers and the movers. We praise God. Goodbye, Pastor Francis. We salute you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Well done. And we praise God for your life, for your witness, for your family, for your work, ministry, interpersonal relationships, and the great impact for the Lord Jesus Christ upon this world. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. I want to salute you, Auntie, for standing strong with Pastor through all the changing scenes of life. Auntie, want to salute you. Okay. May God continue to bless you all.
Thank you, Leela Manase. Thank you for that exhortation. It's all the verses which have been quoted out by each of these speakers are Uncle's favorite verse. And we have two more people who are going to be giving us a short exhortation. The next is going to be Reverend Ebenezer Isaac, the Associate Pastor of the Richmond Town Methodist Church. And he is one person who went into the senior citizens' home and prayed with most of those senior citizens who were staying there. Reverend Ebenezer Isaac.
Good evening. My deepest condolences to the family and friends who have gathered here. And today we come here to celebrate the life of Pastor Francis. And as Paul mentioned, I had the privilege of staying close to the senior citizen home. And oftentimes when I would go and visit them, more than me comforting them, I would be comforted. And in this brief moments of my conversation with Pastor Francis, sometimes you come across people, just in that brief moment, they touch your life, they impact your life. And today, thank you for giving me this privilege to to bring this brief exaltation before you. One of Pastor Francis's favorite verses is 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. It says, "I've fought the good fight, I've finished the race, and I've kept the faith." And when we look closely at these verses, we find comfort and encouragement in why he loved especially this verse. You see, Paul's life ministry provided this powerful example for modeling Christ today. And not only did he fight the good fight, not only did he finish the race, but he kept the faith. And when I think about Pastor Francis, this has been very true in his life. And all of us who we know him, we know that he has fought the good fight, that he is passionate before God in everything that he did, that he gave all of his life in the service to the Lord, that he has finished the race well, and that he has always been a man of faith. Paul had no regrets. And in my conversation with him, I saw love, I saw compassion, I saw tenderness. I saw his tender heart towards people around the senior citizen home, and just being there, just to watch him, to be able to care for the needs, pray for them. Every morning he would do his Bible study, even after retirement, even at this age, he would actually, in the morning, he would have Bible studies. He would just, you know, listen to people. So he was a great listener. And we see, after Jesus had taken control of his life, he had lived a life fullest, fulfilling all that Jesus had charged that he had empowered him to do. And today we praise God for Pastor Francis. We praise God for his life and the way that he has well lived. So our prayer is that as believers, that we will also have this great sense of fulfillment as Pastor Francis did, as Paul presents to us in this message. May we take comfort, saying that may we be people of no regret. May we be people who have said that I have done all that God has asked me to do. And this is true in Pastor Francis's life. So the only regret that I have is I didn't get more time to spend with him. But today I know that he is with the Lord, and we celebrate the legacy that he has left behind and the powerful example of him modeling Christ every single day in his life. And I have seen that in him, and may we also be that model today for people around us. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Ebenezer Isaac. Bishop Samat Kumar had mentioned and said that there were friends who came and sang at the senior citizen home, and now they will render to us a special number. They are called the Friends of St. John's. Please come forward.
In the choir, and oftentimes we would always say, "Mali, sing." So here we are from my last song to him, along with our loving friends who ministered to him during the last few months of his life. The Master's Bouquet.
Death is an angel sent down from above. Send for the birds and the flowers we love. Truly it's so for it. pastors go pay. Loved ones are passing each day and each hour, passing away as the life of a flower. But every bud and each blossom someday will bloom as a flower in the master's bouquet. Gathering flowers for the master's bouquet. Beautiful flowers that will never decay. Gathered by angels and carried away forever to bloom in the master's bouquet. Let us be faithful till life's work is done. Blooming with love till the reaper shall come. To bloom in the master's bouquet. Gathering flowers for the master's bouquet. Beautiful flowers that will never decay. Gathered by angels and carried away forever to bloom in the master's beautiful flowers that will never decay. Gathered by angels and carried away forever to bloom in the master's
Every time I met Uncle, and he always said he always appreciated two groups who came and sang for him. One group was the Friends of St. John's, and the other was the RTMC choir led by Danny and Christy. Every Saturday, faithfully, they used to go at 8 o'clock and sing for them, and it was, he always said it so much encouraged them. Thank you so much for your ministry to Uncle. At this time, we have the Bible reading by Hannah Samuel.
Bible reading is taken from Psalm 91, verses 14 to 16. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
May God add his blessings to the reading of his holy word. We have three short tributes that we will be hearing now. The first one is Mr. Simon Chandran. He is a pastor from Malaysia. He has sent in a recorded message. Would you kindly play that now?
I'm thankful to God for giving me this privilege to pay this tribute to my spiritual father, Reverend Dr. Francis Sundararaj, who played a major role in my life and in the lives of many pastors in Malaysia. And today, service as a service of celebration for his life. His life was a life of legacy left behind for us to follow. Reverend Francis Sundararaj came to Malaysia in 1967 by the invitation of the Tamil Methodist Church and he served in Raub as his first pastorate. And 1969, he was transferred to Ipoh, and there he came and served faithfully. He was instrumental in bringing revival to the churches, and he started the first vacation Bible school. And later, many young people gave their lives to Christ for full time, and they were sent to Yotmal, UBS, and there they got trained, came back to Malaysia, and served the Tamil Methodist churches vibrantly. And this evening, on behalf of all the pastors of Malaysia who went to Yotmal, who were under his pastoral care, and my family, we would like to convey our deepest condolences to Auntie Banu, Malika, and her husband John, son Vinod, wife Sandra, and daughter Rachel. We want to convey our deepest condolences to them. This grand tribute is for a man who has lived a life worthy unto the Lord. And today's service is a service of celebration for God's goodness in his life. He lived 85 years full of fruitfulness. He was God's chosen vessel. From the time he gave his life to Christ and started serving the Lord, he was faithful. In 1967, he came here. Then he went back in 1970 to India, then to Princeton and to Yotmal, and then came back in 1970. And then he served in Brickfields for a number of years, also including Klang, Port Klang, Bunting. He was a district superintendent for the churches here. And in all his service, wherever he went, he brought life to the church, revival to the church, and he was a great blessing.
We apologize that I think it's stuck out there. That was Reverend Simon Chandran, and he is from Malaysia, and he considers himself as a spiritual son of Reverend Francis Sundararaj. He had many people whom he had groomed, and we have somebody from Hyderabad, Mr. Robin Dharmaraj, who has come all the way from Hyderabad, and he has been associated with him in the Bible studies, in the fellowship, and he was just talking to me, and he said for 30 long years they've been doing that together. And he has come from Hyderabad, and he will pay a short tribute to him.
Good evening, everybody. Praise the Lord. I thank Mrs. Banu and children for giving this opportunity. I first met Pastor Francis in Shamshabad in the year 1977, when Pili Charles Aunty and Bush Aunty were conducting the Sifi, Telugu Sifi. I went to attend as a Sunday school superintendent in the workshop, but both the aunties made me as a faculty. And on the final day, Pastor Francis saw me and caught hold of me as a fishes of men. From then onwards, I was closely associated in various meetings and various, if I start telling what are the various committees, meetings, or spiritual groups, there is no limit for it. We have to keep on telling. Leela Manasa has already told so many names. In which group he was not there, that we can say that in everything, Methodist youth, and then city cadet, and IMS, so many groups. If I start telling, I think it'll take a long time. So he was everywhere. And especially even the youth, when I want to tell you here, we have heard many spiritual matters about pastor, we all know. So I tell something which you do not know. The main thing is our Bible study. Of course, I'll not go out of the way. So he was a very handsome, and both her handsome couple, they were attracted. Not only just physically, spiritually, the pastor was to give counseling in such a way, they cannot refuse or they cannot just give up. They have to listen, and in such a way that he presents, they follow it. And the youth, you know, every youth everywhere, they have the hero worship. They used to call him, he is like a Shashi Kapoor. So they are attracted, not only this thing, he's handsome. So they were attracted. Then he used to keep his hand on their shoulder, very close to their mouth to mouth. He used to give the counseling, and he used to attract the people. And then he takes them deeply into the spiritual matters. Whenever there is something wrong with any group, any church, anything, he will not be a silent spectator. He will try to get into that and give advice and try to improve the matters. So many people admire him and they're attracted. A few things that I want to tell you is that he's a product of the St. Paul's Church in Chennai. I think many may be knowing that St. Paul's has produced many great men. Even Pastor Sundararaj studied there. And his seniors and senior most people, like Bishop Chellappa, George Chellappa, and George Armanagam, who was my father, father-in-law. Later, he became the pastor's teacher. I like that, when he used to have high respect and regard for them. Later, all those people, when pastor has become the pastor of that church, they started giving high regard and respect to this young pastor. So, coming to, let me not get out of the way, it's coming to the Hyderabad Bible study. He was the founder of St. George's Bible study. He used to regularly come, regularly have Bible study if I'm correct, it is on Friday. He used to have Bible study in St. George's Church. We used to sometimes, on and off, I used to attend. But later he started Bible study in Vijayanagar Colony in Hyderabad. It is shifted to Mossop Tank. And he was always study the Bible. He was thorough with the Word of God. His expounding the Word of God was excellent. And the way he teaches in the Bible study, he will not say, this is the way you teach. It is not the one way. He makes all the members to participate and make them to discuss, and then they come to conclusion. He used to guide them, they should not go out of the way. Sometimes, unfortunately, when people are very enthusiastic, they keep dragging with the questions. Mrs. Bono used to be there. You are going out of the way. So we used to really enjoy Mrs. Bono also checking up sometimes. If I take little this side, even whenever there's some functions and all that, people are unruly, they take the plate and come standing there. We miss Mrs. Bono. If she were to be there, she will go there and say, please give way for the other people, like that. Both the couples, sometimes they do not agree with each other, but it was excellent. God's make such a way without each other. Reverend Francis Sundararaj, without Mrs. Bono, he cannot do anything. And in the similar way, Mrs. Bono also very strict and all that seemed to be. We all will get, but I think without telling anything, without the help of Mrs. Bono, you cannot do. Yeah. Then that Bible study was excellent, and we continue to have our Bible study, except this because of the COVID, we just stopped for some time. And it is continuing, and we praise God, and it will continue. And we wanted to tell one more thing. Anywhere, all through his life, he was wonderful. He used to influence everywhere and guide the people and bring the spiritual changes in the people. And we praise God. When actually I said condolences, Mrs. Bonu said, no, we are celebrating. Truly, it is true. My pastor used to say, to live is Christ for me, to die is gain. It is truly, he has gained. God has taken him in a better place, forever with the Lord, always praising and waiting for all of us to go and meet him. I praise God for giving this opportunity. Thank you very much, all.
Thank you, Mr. Robin. We had told everybody it's 3 minutes, so he was keeping on looking at me, whether I was giving him a hand signal at that. You know, one of the things that Uncle always wanted was he loved the Adyar Ananda Bhavan coffee and vada. So it was one of my weekly duties to take him out on a ride to Shantinagar bus stand, where we have the A to B, where we will sit in the car and have coffee and vada, and he really enjoyed it. But come COVID, strict orders from Banu Aunty, no going out. And she put the blame on Vinod and Ruth and said, they told us that he should not go out. But he always would ever, whenever he called me, he said, let's go out. Last Thursday, the Thursday that he passed along, he said, we will go to the hospital, and from there, we will go to A to B, have vada and coffee. But I'm sure he's having vada and coffee in the midst of the Lord. God has been so good. And one of the persons whom he always called, apart from me or my sister-in-law, Hannah, was Mr. Ebenezer of Every Home Crusade. And just a call, phone call, and he was always here to help Uncle. And he will come and pay his tribute. Mr. Ebenezer.
Praise the Lord. We read in 2 Timothy 4:7, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. I came to know Reverend Francis Sundararaj sir in 2019 through our ex-director, Reverend M.M. Prasad. When they shifted to Bangalore, I used to visit them now and then, as my office is very near to this place. Since sir was ministry-minded, whenever I visited them, he used to ask about my ministry works and family. He knew that gospel sharing is very challenging in these days. Sir used to pray and encourage me through the God's word. He was a very humble person and grateful for whatever the small help I do for sir. He loved me so much that he called me as his spiritual son. Even last week, I had the privilege to spend time with sir. We know each other for a very short period, but I can never forget sir in my life. I thank our Lord for enable me to help sir till his last day. I thank the family for giving me this opportunity to share a few things about Reverend Francis Sundararaj sir. Thank you, one and all.
All the tributes are over, but we have the family who will come forward and
say a tribute, an exhortation, and an expression of gratitude. Vinod will come first, John Samuel will come next, and Mallika Ruth will come after that.
I am Vinod Sundararaj, and thank you all for coming. So many friends from Hyderabad that I haven't seen in 20 plus years. So on behalf of my family, this tribute is on behalf of my family, my mother, my sister, brother-in-law, my wife, Sandra, and my daughter, Rachel, and also my extended family in the U.S., the family of my father's older brother, who passed away about 3 years ago, and his younger brother, Lionel. So this is a tribute on behalf of those families. I'm also going to reflect in 2 minutes the humor of my father. But before that, I want to read a few notes from family. And this is from my uncle, Liney uncle, who is the younger brother of my father. My brother was a true man of God, whom he served faithfully to the end, and I never saw spiritual pride in him. He always said, "We were saved by the grace of God." He was a humble and honest man. He never judged others, only saw good in people. Every time I talked to him, he would always end our conversation with a prayer for me and my family. I will miss his prayers. He was a great source of encouragement and blessing in my life. The next note comes from Ranjit Bhaskar, who's the older son of James Bhaskar, my father's oldest son. And he is writing this on behalf of his mother, Padmini, his sister Shalini, and his brother Ravi. My uncle was always told us to help the poor and the oppressed. He was a committed Christian. He was a man of God who just didn't preach, but practiced daily. He helped many people, not only by spreading the word of God, but also by helping them practically. He could have lived a comfortable life, but he chose to serve God. Next to our father, Francis' uncle was our spiritual mentor. He was truly admired by all of us. He was loved and will be missed by our families. By the grace of God, he graced his family presence on us. We will miss him dearly. For me, I know there was a lot of titles today. General Secretary, Pastor, Honorary Doctorate. To me, he was my dad, and he was also, I bestowed upon him the title of Doctorate of WhatsApp. The reason I say this is because while traveling 20 hours on two different plane rides for the funeral, I was looking through all the different messages on WhatsApp. And I never interacted on these groups, but what touched me the most was the constant theme around, I just talked to him. I just received a note from him. He just prayed with me. I'm shocked. It dawned on me that my dad was, even after retirement, his love for people continued. And he saw this as a ministry. WhatsApp was just a medium. He was a friend, a family man, a friend to us, and he was a funny man. There are many stories of his humor, one of which, every time he would come to the U.S., I was the only option for him to take him to the barbershop. And he would make it known to the lady that, of course, this is my son. And the question would always be, how come you have more hair than he does? And his answer to the lady would be, he is more wise than me. And he is much taller. I will miss my father. There's a song, a verse from the song says, there's not a day that goes by that I don't see you. You will live in all of, through all of us, in all the better parts of us. We will hope to be standing with you in the sun, and we will fight this race from here on. Thank you very much.
Thanks to each of you for taking time to come and join us today. And here's a 3-minute exhortation that I want to bring to you all. And one of my father-in-law's very favorite verses was Hebrews 12, verse 1. Therefore, since we have such a great cloud of witnesses surrounding us, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. You know, in this verse, which was one of his favorite verses, I've heard him personally mention it to me, there are three parts which I want to quickly highlight to you. For the first part is, since we are surrounded by so great witnesses, you must understand in the spiritual world, they can see us, we can't see them. We are surrounded by a multitude of witnesses. You know, my wife is a professional psychologist and counselor, and she will tell you, when they do counseling, it's a one-way mirror. The person who's there being counseled will be there in the room, but the other counselors in a one-way mirror will be watching what is happening in the counseling room. In a similar way, right now here in life, God has got those thousands of witnesses from the Old Testament times, the New Testament times, who are watching us run this race. They can see us, we can't see them. And that's a great encouragement. There's nothing known as privacy in the world of the spiritual realm. In Europe, they have it, they call it GDPR. In Singapore, they call it PDPA, where privacy laws are very tight. But when it comes to the spiritual realm, there's nothing that's private. God can see, the cloud of witnesses see us. And that's why the writer to the Hebrews was encouraging us, make sure you are living up to their expectations. And also reminding us, you're not alone. People are there watching you. They've gone through this race before. They've had the same challenges you have as well. And they want to see you come out well. What an encouragement that we are being watched, we are being observed, that eventually, one day, we all will be able to rewind the tape and then be able to see what others were able to see even as our lives was panning out. The second part of the verse is where I thought I must highlight as well. It's a word of warning. Let us lay aside every weight and sin which besets us so easily. You know, in our human nature, till we die, we are going to have to fight sin. That's why Martin Luther said, till I die, I will be repenting. Till I die, I know there will be mistakes made. I will slip, I will stumble, and I need to go and be asking the Lord's forgiveness, to be washed in his blood. What a reminder. Many of us think we can still carry on without wanting to lay aside every weight of sin which ensnares us. Who wants to run a race with some weights around your leg? Would you even try? But that's exactly what many of us at times attempt to do in our spiritual lives. When we ought to be cleaning up, when we ought to be repenting, when we ought to be going to the Lord and saying, Lord, deliver me from what the Bible calls a besetting sin. This is creeping over me again and again. And God says, get rid of it. And the last part of the verse is, let us run the race with patience. I saw my father-in-law run the race with patience. He had his own limitations. He had his own shortcomings. All of us in the family will know that. But I saw him run the race. When he could have just retired, when he could have given up on ministry. I saw him, you know, those who are in the Koinonia chat group, the watch and pray chat group, how faithfully he will take some nuggets, some snippets, and then share it with others for their encouragement. And I'm thankful he has run his race with endurance, and he has finished his race. But what about you and me? Will we be living our lives with this weight of sin which so easily ensnares us? Or will we do due diligence in cleaning up through repentance, through everything that God wants us to be cleaned out from, so that we can run the race with patience, because we are freer, we are lighter, and we are able to accomplish God's kingdom purposes? And I saw my father-in-law do that. And I hope his life will be an encouragement to you and to me, because we have a race ahead of us. How we finish is in your hands and in my hands. Thank you.
Daddy had a grateful spirit. Even for little things, he was so particular with his thank yous. So here I go, grateful to our God, our Lord Jesus, for granting him his heart's desire. He did not want to be bedridden. And as Shanti, my sister-in-law, worded it beautifully, your dad walked from earth's door to heaven's door. He literally walked to the car to go to the hospital, Bangalore at RTMC Seniors Home. So I'm grateful to Pastor Sebastian and the staff who welcomed them warmly in 2019. I'm grateful to our family on my beloved John's side, Hannah, my sister-in-law, and my dear friend who cared for him till the end, and whom Dad said was like a daughter. My brothers-in-law, Paul, and as he said, you know, they had their moments together in Ananda Bhavan, and also Dad said he had a gentle care over him. My other brother-in-law, thank you to Hudson, I say Advocate Joshua, for all the care and support he gave to my brother and me in our care for our parents. Thank you, Shanti, for being there when he needed any medical help. Thank you to our cousins, Suresh and Muni, for their love and affection. Thank you, Bishop Sampath Kumar, for your friendship in these last days of his life. Thank you, Brother Ebi, again. Thank you, Pastor Ebi, for your pastoral care, and for your dear wife, Dinah, for her medical care. And I want to say a special thanks, thanks to a special group of people, and they are in the senior citizens' home for the last 3 years. Dave, who cooked all his favorite food, you know, his aloo puri, his dosa and idli, how his face used to light up. Thank you, Sanjay, for your care and service to Dad. And these two special ladies, Shanta and Selvi, for your commitment and for your affection. And also to Selvam and Balaji and Ram. And I think even for Hannah and Hudson's staff, like Shiva and Jones, thank you so much. Now, I would like to say a special thanks, a special thanks to our special friends and family, for those who have come all the way. Our special friends from Hyderabad, Robin Anna, Dr. Sujayana, Sunny and Amar, Jasper and Shai Marka, who are here. And then in the family, one of his favorite cousins, Uncle Mano, and I don't know whether Uncle Jacob too is here. Thank you. And please, I will again apologize if I'm missing out. Please, it's not intentional. I want to say in his last days, thank you to Anu and Nitin, whom he was very fond of and whom God timed their visit to see him in his the last times, and their dear parents. Now, thank you to his singing friends that he was so fond of, the friends of St. John and Danny and Christy. And now I would say, you know, for those who are watching, thank you to his Malaysia family, thank you to his Hyderabad family. And when I say family, I mean the body of Christ, or the community that we had in the body of Christ. His social media family, Koinonia, and Facebook family. Now, thank you so much for all those who helped in the logistics for this service and who stood by us. Thank you to the media team, Simon, Akash, and Benji. And thank you for each of you who participated today, the pastors, Pastor Bishop Sampath and Leela Kalataka, and all, I mean, Brother Abby, Robin, and of course, Uncle Simon Chantran. So thank you so much, and again, please forgive me if I have left out anyone, but Dad would have wanted me to say thank you. And if I have 2 minutes, my dad was not in any way a perfect man. But then what I really loved about my dad was we could call him out when he was wrong. And that was very, very special of my dad. We could just call him out and say, Daddy, you are so proud. Or Daddy, that's wrong. That's not nice. Or Daddy, you're too harsh. And he was always humble and respectful to take it. We'll miss him, and especially for me, he's been my bestie. Thank you, and I really thank God for this earthly father that he blessed me with.
Thank you, Malika, Ruth, John, and Vinod for that tribute. We've just come to the end of the service. We will have the closing hymn, and then followed by the closing prayer, which is going to be also the prayer of comfort by Reverend Sebastian Ravi Kumar, and then the benediction by Bishop Sambat Kumar. Shall we? You've been sitting for a long time. Would you just rise to your feet, even as we sing this, his favorite hymn, Abide With Me, Fast Falls the Eventide.
Abide with me. As the church bell goes 485 times in honor of the departed, we all will bow our heads, close our eyes, look to God in prayer for His comfort, for His visitation to our hearts. Let us pray. Loving gracious Heavenly Father, we come before your throne of grace giving thanks to you for the life lived in your service for your glory by your dear son, late Reverend Francis Sundararaj. Lord, we thank you for each and every year in your service that he spent and invested your treasures in the lives of so many. Lord, we thank you for the impact of your servant upon so many lives. Lord, we give you thanks for your faithfulness and all that you meant to him while he was alive. Lord, we also thank you for the eternal life that we have in Jesus Christ our Lord. We continue to live, whether we are here in this body or out of this body, we belong to you. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful assurance that we have from the scriptures. Death has been swallowed up in victory. As Paul writes to Corinthians, "Where, O death, is your sting? Where, O death, is your power?" The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is law. But praise be to God, he has given us victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. What a comforting statement that Paul made, and this is our privilege and opportunity and greatest blessing to read and to experience, go through all that we learn from the Word. Lord, we thank you. Yes, we thank you for his disciplined life. We thank you for his doctrinal life. We thank you for his directional life. We thank you for all the good legacy left behind. Master, life lived in your presence, and that was pleasing always in your sight. As you have rightly said through the scriptures, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Lord, we thank you for family and the family members, relatives and friends. On the one side, church mourns because church has lost one of her faithful servants. On the other hand, we all believers, we all brothers and sisters celebrate his life. Lord, we thank you for all the spiritual experiences that we go through. This will always usher us into your holy presence. Lord, we thank you. Master, help each one of us at this moment to look beyond the shadow of death and concentrate upon the life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Thank you, Lord, for Auntie and your comfort in her life. Continue to stay close to her more than she is to herself. Continue to speak to her, encourage her, build her. Lord, she is not alone. We all are with her. We thank you for the fellowship that we have with one another, above all with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As we depart from here, send us with your peace and the promise of resurrection. We give you thanks, we give you glory, Father, we love you. This we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to say while we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory. Amen.
Now may the God of peace, that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep through the blood of the everlasting covenant, equip you to do everything good, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Kindly be seated. Dear friends, you can now pay your last respects to Reverend Dr. Francis Sundararaj by making use of the middle aisle and then wishing the family on to my left, and then kindly be seated. Thank you. So coffee and snacks also arranged at the premises.
So good to see you. Thank you. When the roll is
the trump, when the roll is in the roll. Number five.
Number one first.
Number four. Right?